Hello and welcome to the BakingMad.com kitchen, where today I'm going to show you how to make jam. Now jam is very easy, but there are some rules that you do need to follow. Now a lot of fruits, well, they vary in pectin, and pectin is the gel that sets the jam, which naturally occurs in some fruits. Things like blackberries and strawberries and raspberries are low in pectin, so it's ideal to use a jam sugar. But if you're using fruits that are high in pectin, such as black currants and red currants and plums, and if you're making marmalade, which has got a lot of pectin in it, you just need preserving sugar. Preserving sugar has got a large crystal size, so it dissolves really easily, and it also gives you a really clear set when you're making jam. But for blackberry jam that I'm going to make today, we're using jam sugar with added pectin. And generally speaking, with jams, you're using equal quantity of fruit to sugar. And if you've got a low pectin fruit, like blackberries and strawberries, you usually add some lemon juice, which I've already added to the pan. And that helps extract the natural pectin from the fruit itself. So you just pop all your fruit into a pan. And you do need a big pan. You don't have to have a preserving pan, but I think a preserving pan, if you're going to make a lot of jam, is a good investment. Because actually what you want is a wide surface area, because you've got to boil away the juice to kind of reduce the quantity so that it sets. And if you've got a big pan, it's much easier to do that. So first of all, you cook the fruit until it's soft, and then we're going to add the sugar. You can see now why you need a big pan too, because once you add that sugar, it increases the quantity quite considerably. Heat the sugar gently until the sugar's dissolved and you can't feel any grains on the bottom of the pan. Now I'm going to use a jam or sugar thermometer, because you've got to boil the jam until it reaches setting point, and a sugar thermometer has the jam setting point on it, but it's not a foolproof guide. What you also need is some saucers in the fridge chilling that we're going to put a spoonful of jam on, and then we can test the set by running our finger through the set jam. But pop the sugar thermometer in, and once the sugar's dissolved, then you can increase the heat until you get a rolling boil, and the liquid will evaporate off until you reach setting point. Now you can see now that it's coming up to a rapid boil, and again that's another reason why you need a big pan, because you do want it to boil. The best test is when you run your finger through, you can see that the jam has formed skin and is wrinkling and it feels thick. That way you know that you've got a really good set. You should turn the heat off while you're setting or testing the set of the jam, because you don't want it to overboil. But once you know that setting point's reached, if you've got a lot of scum on top of the jam, just spoon that off, and that's the cook's treat. Okay, now we're ready to pot the jam, and be really careful, because of course this is absolutely scalding hot. So I use a measuring jug to pour the jam into my jars. And you can buy a funnel that fits over the top of the jar so that you don't spill it over the edge if you want to get yourself some more jam making equipment. And you need to fill the jam jars right up to the very brim, because you need to expel all the air from the jam so that no mould can grow in there. Now to cover your jars, add the sterilised lids and put them on loosely to start with, because you want a little bit of the heat to escape, and then come back about 30 minutes later and screw them on tightly. And what happens as the jam cools, it will pull the lid down and create a vacuum, and then you know that it's absolutely airtight and will keep in the larder for probably 2 years if you want to. If you don't have jam jar lids, you can use jam pot covers, and you buy these. They've got these little wax discs, and you put the wax side down onto the jam. You should trim the top actually so that it fits. And the wax will melt against the surface of the jam. Make sure you get out any air bubbles. As I say, you should really trim this disc to fit. Get rid of any air bubbles. And then you put a cellophane disc on top. And secure it with an elastic band. So don't be afraid to make jam, it's really quite simple, and there's lots of recipes on the bakingmad.com website with all sorts of different fruits. And I'm just going to tuck in some of my blackberry jam on some Lincolnshire plum bread. Delish!